السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
ازيك يا
سلام
عليكم. خود ہی آپ نے کرنا ہے؟ میں نے کرنا ہے، میں نے خود افرٹ کرنی ہے. اچھا، ڈاکٹر مظفر چودھری صاحب تلاوت.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا وأخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. The English translation of these two verses, verse 286-287, chapter 2. This messenger of ours believes in that which what has been revealed to him from his Lord, and so do the believers. All of them believe in Allah and in his angels and in his books and in his messengers, saying, we make no distinction between any of his messengers. And they say, we have heard and we are obedient. Our Lord, we implore thy forgiveness, and to thy is the returning. Allah burdens not any soul beyond its capacity. It shall have the reward it earns, and it shall get the punishment it incurs. Our Lord, do not punish us if we forget or fall into error. And our Lord, lay not on us a responsibility as thou didst lay upon those before us. Our Lord, burden us not with what we have not the strength to bear, and efface our sins, and grant us forgiveness, and have mercy on us. Thou art our master, so help us against the disbelieving people.
Dr. Sayyid Muzaffar Sahib, Chairman, and the MIT Association annual report.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Our beloved Hazur, Assalamu Alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hazur, on behalf of our guests and members, I would like to welcome you to our meeting. And Hazur, it is our great honor, privilege, and pleasure, and we are very grateful that you can spare some time for our meeting. We certainly do not feel worthy of this, and it is only your kindness, magnanimity towards us that you have actually spared this moment and have come to this meeting, and we will always be grateful for that. I will now briefly give a report on Association's humble work, which has been only possible due to Huzoor's prayers resulting in Allah Ta'ala's graciousness. Being a medical organization, we provide manpower in terms of doctors, nurses and paramedics to wherever they are required, to whomsoever need be. And we help our sister organizations like Humanity First in UK, Humanity First in America, and we have got close links with Medical Association in Pakistan and Medical Association in Canada. We even have links with homeopathy, and we work very closely with Hafiz Saab, and whenever he needs some medicine to get better quickly, he do come to our camp as well in Jalsaga. And we do refer patient to Hafiz Saab as well whenever the need be. Dr. Humayun, who's a consultant hematologist, he has actually provided technical assistance to Medical Association in USA who are setting up a lab in Debose. Dr. Shahnawaz, who is Medical Director of Humanity First, is doing the medical side for Humanity First, to which we are contributing, and is conducting courses in disaster response, which are going very well. In UK, Azur, other than advising on medical queries, we provide medical cover for Jalsa as well, which for 2 weeks of hospitality period, we provide cover for three sites for 24 hours. In Battle for Dhu, it starts even sooner than hospitality period, and it goes on quite a few weeks after hospitality period. And Dr. Amjad, Dr. Manan, and Dr. Mangat have been instrumental in providing this cover. In the Jalsaga itself, Alhamdulillah, everything went well in last year and year before that. Dr. Islam and Dr. Rihanna provide medical cover on the Lajna side. Alhamdulillah, most of the duties went well. We once had an unannounced visit from Amir Saab and Nasir Khan Saab. After that, we tightened our security and they weren't able to come in afterwards. Azur, we last year promised that we will set up an endoscopy unit in Fazlul Umar Hospital, which is dear to our hearts and is dear to you as well. And Alhamdulillah, by sheer Allah Ta'ala's graciousness, we were able to do that. It was a team effort where we actually got the equipment first, shipped it to Pakistan, and then took it to Rawa, and then set it up there. Alhamdulillah, it's now up and running. Hazur is all too familiar with endoscopy unit in Rawa, but Alhamdulillah, now it actually looks much better than what it was before. It hasn't got state-of-the-art equipment, but it has got equipment that actually works. You can actually do an endoscopy, make a video, and you can give it to the patient that they can actually keep. It's neat and clean environment where a patient can come in and have a consultation and recover afterwards and then go home. And we have, Alhamdulillah, now got scopes for every eventuality that we need. The first step was to equip the unit with all the endoscopes, and inshallah, next step is to start training as well. Azur, the other thing that, again, by Azur's prayers and Allah Ta'ala's graciousness, we have been able to achieve is this hepatitis vaccination program that we started. After having advice from liver doctors, we thought the best time to immunize would be children when they enter school, which we have done, and alhamdulillah, we have been able to immunize over 1,600 children in all schools in Rabwa, and they have had their second dose last month. They'll have their final dose in 5 months' time, and then they are immunized for a year. And we, inshallah, hope to continue this every year so that no children will have hepatitis B again. So we are a small organization, but we have got our bigger aims, and I'm sure, inshallah, with Huzoor's prayers, we will do our best to achieve those. We have now equipped endoscopy unit, and we feel going to Rabwa, Pakistan or Africa and doing few procedure is a good thing, but the best thing would be to train the doctor so that they can carry on the good work. This is what, inshallah, we hope to do. And it's not only doctors training, it's nurses training as well. And thankfully, in spite of the situation in Pakistan, two of the nurses in Scunthorpe General Hospital have very kindly volunteered, and hopefully they'll be going in March to train the endoscopy nurses as well as ward nurses to the standards. And I think it will, inshallah, have a very good positive impact. The second thing that we would like to do is to attain a charity status, so that we can, that will open up other avenues for us. We hope to, inshallah, have a recognition with World Health Organization. I was told that whenever you request a recognition from them, they look at your credentials. And I think with we've been able to show that we have actually done work on the ground, we hope to have a very good positive response from them, and inshallah that will open up opportunities and avenues to not only limit our vaccination program in Rabwa or in Pakistan, we hope to move on to Africa. I would like to thank Huzoor for his gracious time again, and request Azur to please remember us in your prayers so that we can carry on this work. JazakAllah.
Any prayer distribution on anything?
Yeah, Jesus.
Yeah, what? Azur.
In order to promote research on Azur's instructions, we have had three prizes, and the first prize is for the first prize is for Dr. Abdul Salam on poster 7, Dr. Carmichael will collect on her behalf.
Sure.
Dr. Carmichael.
She is not present here?
She is, but she's on the other side, so we thought. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And the second poster is for Mr. Muhammad Arif. Dr. Carmichael is again
going to take this.
It's a family affair, Azur, uh-huh. Today. He's got all three. And this is for Professor Amtul Carmichael.
Please. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم I'm happy to be amongst you tonight. I don't remember having addressed you directly in any of your previous functions. Or if I did, it has been a long time. Hence, doing so today gives me a great pleasure to be present amongst you. One major purpose of establishing this association is to serve humanity, whereby MD doctors join hands in assisting suffering people, volunteering their time and resources to provide medical aid to the needy. It gives me pleasure to see that the Ahmadiyya Medical Association, under the auspices of Humanity First, is diligently serving humanity throughout the world, whereby wherever disaster have occurred in the world, be it the earthquake or floods in Pakistan, disasters in Latin America and Indonesia, or disasters in Africa, you have been there actively providing assistance to the victims. May Allah reward you for this. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam laid much emphasis on serving humanity. His whole life was spent in the service of Allah and His creation. His entire life was a practical example of one of his Persian poetic verses where he says, the English rendering of that is that my purpose and my desire is to serve creation. This alone is my mission. This alone is my responsibility and this is my way. May Allah Almighty enable us all, and more specifically you, the MD doctors, to fulfill the wishes of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam. Having acquired the talent and knowledge of treating the ill, may Allah enable you to provide these services to the best of your abilities. There is a hadith which states that the best knowledge is of two types, the knowledge of religion and the knowledge of bodies. You are the people being referred to in this hadith. Therefore, may Allah enable you to utilize all your talents and capabilities to achieve this target of serving humanity and attain the maximum heights in your field. Doctors in these countries before I go further, here I would like to commend your effort you have been doing in research. I have just seen the exhibition or the display of your research. Allah increase your knowledge and capabilities. doctors in these countries are normally affluent in terms of wealth or considered to be affluent. And by the grace of Allah, where our doctors sacrifice for the cause of the Jamaat, they also sacrifice their wealth for suffering mankind. Where you spend your money and time to treat the ill. I would like to urge you to also partake in funding some of our special projects. When the Tahir Heart Institute in Rawa was being constructed, I asked them, the doctors in USA, to fund this project. By Allah's grace, they happily accepted this responsibility and sacrificed, sacrificed tremendously for this cause, bearing about 90% of the cost. Those of you who have visited the Tahir Heart Institute will agree with me that it is a state-of-the-art institute, providing the best care possible to all its patients. Coming from diverse backgrounds, although the Tahir Heart Institute is well equipped and functioning well with the equipment provided by the American MD doctors, or the most of the equipment provided by those doctors, it still needs dialysis machines. It is trying to acquire at least 4 machines to start with, which cost about 9 to 10 million rupees. As you are aware, these are sometimes required for the successful treatment of heart patients. At present, due to the unavailability of these machines, we are forced to transfer patients to other hospitals outside Rawa, where generally the service offered is not up to the mark. In light of this, we are trying to equip Tahir Heart Institute with these machines. Here, I would like to urge you to come forward and help to bear the cost of these machines. A while ago, a local doctor gave me about £10,000, which I sent to Tahir Heart for this purpose. Similarly, another amount received was also sent there. This is almost equivalent to £10,000. We are still short of about 7 to 8 million rupees. That is, in terms of pounds, almost £50,000, or more or less £50,000, which I wish the Ahmadiyya Medical Association UK should try to bear as much as it can. May Allah enable you to achieve this. I am also happy to observe that each year some research papers are read at this event. This is a big achievement of Ahmadi doctors. As Masih Mau'ud alayhi salatu wasalam said, my followers will excel so much in knowledge and enlightenment that they will leave everyone speechless by their argument, their science, and the light of their truthfulness. May Allah enable you, enable our MD doctors, MD researchers, to serve humanity to the best of their ability and release suffering humanity from the clutches of their misery. In the end, I would like to read some excerpts of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam. He says, "My state is such that if I am engaged in prayer, but someone is in pain and I cannot hear him, then I feel someone is in pain and I can hear him, then I feel like breaking off my prayer and help him if it is possible. And that to whatever extent is possible, I show sympathy to him." Then he says, "It is against morality to fail to help your brother when he faces any difficulty or is in pain. If you are not in a position to help in any way, then at the very least you should pray for him." He further on says, "Apart from this, I say that when dealing with Hindus or any non-Ahmadis, you should display the same example of high morals and thus treat them with compassion. Indeed, you should never be negligent in this respect. It is my fervent prayer that Allah helps you to discharge the duties you owe to humanity to the maximum extent, according to the wishes of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, and be a source of pride for Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam in the Jamaat. Ameen." Now please join me in silent prayer. Ameen. I